Hi, I'm Bo English with Keller Williams Realty Gulf Coast and English & Co. team, and I have with me
Jordan Reyes
with Goosehead Insurance. And today we're going to be discussing flood insurance. So, Jordan, flood insurance has been a huge topic lately, especially with the floods. Like in Pensacola, we had the big flood in 2014 that kind of came out of nowhere. A lot of people didn't have flood insurance, or they were not in a flood zone, but yeah, they still got flooded. And now you also have a lot of private insurers getting into flood and offering more options than just the National Flood Insurance Program.
Absolutely.
So tell me, like, how are you guys at Goosehead addressing that? What options do you guys have? Mm-hmm. I know a lot of people just carry the National Flood Insurance Program and that's it, but you also have some private insurers.
Absolutely. So to date, I believe there's about 14 carriers that are private that writes all over Florida. And that's a really good question you bring up, because we often correct a lot of folks is there's really no such thing as no flood zone. There's either you're in a moderate risk, a low risk, or in a high risk. But Right. As you can tell, in 2014, there's a lot of X zones that flooded.
Right.
So that tells you right there that there's no such thing as a no flood zone.
Yeah.
We have private carriers that we insure. So really pros and cons. They're not affected by the government shutdown. So that doesn't affect them. They can dictate whatever rates they want. So because they're not upheld by FEMA, they can charge however much they want or however little they want. And they don't have to go by any rates every year. At any point, it can go down and it can go up. So I guess that's one of the cons of having a private flood insurer. One of the pros is they don't require elevation certificate. So oftentimes we see that's a holdback.
Wow,
when it comes
so
to
even the private insurers don't require the elevation certificate.
Absolutely.
Now, if you get it, does it help?
Oh, absolutely. In fact, we had one this morning where the rate went down $300 just because we were able to measure the lowest elevation of the house. But it's not required. If you're willing to pay a little bit of a surcharge, they have a standardized price they will charge.
Explain, what is the elevation certificate? Because a lot of people are confused about that.
So an elevation certificate basically is just a surveyor goes in the property and they basically measure what's the lowest elevation of the house where, you know, the equipment is. It could be an AC, a water heater. And they also measure you as far as your elevation to the sea level. And it basically gives you a whole synopsis of, you know, how risky the place is or how it is built. Is it up to code? Does it have blowout walls? So on and so forth, and because not every house is standardized in a neighborhood.
Yeah. Some of these old houses from the 70s and 80s that still exist
Absolutely. Weren't
built with the blowout walls.
It's not. They're not. It's not until recently that they're actually like put in place, especially in the VE zone in Santa Rosa. You're not even allowed to build a house that's not up to code anymore.
Yeah, absolutely. So another thing that I want to talk about too is how FEMA can change the flood zones.
Yes, they have a map panel date that they go by. And the biggest thing with that is just because in 1977 you're in an X zone doesn't mean that today you're going to be an X zone as well.
Right.
So oftentimes we have people that their mapping have kind of altered a little bit. And we have folks that are telling us like, hey, down the road is an A zone, we're in an X zone, should we buy the flood? And one of the leverage of having a flood insurance on an X zone is if at any point that turned into an A zone, you can grandfather that X zone and give it to your buyer.
Yeah.
Because we have seen a lot of folks where, you know, contracts falling through once they finally figured out what the cost of the flood insurance is.
Yeah, so I have a listing, for example, in Gulf Breeze that when I look at the FEMA flood map, that zone is right up against the property. So it's actually an X, but it's right up against, I want to say, maybe a VE or a V or something like that.
Yeah.
And so those buyers or owners should still have a flood policy because FEMA can change the flood insurance like that, the maps like that, and redraw the map, and then somebody who's not grandfathered in could have a super expensive flood policy.
Absolutely, and it's only a matter of time. I mean, especially with Hurricane Irma last year and Hurricane Michael this year, that's bound to happen anytime soon. There's a reason why FEMA is in a deficit of $11 billion, even though they've been pardoned so much money they've paid out already. So that tells you that not everybody in the mountaintop is going to buy flood insurance, whereas they're losing money paying the flood zone claims.
So I guess the big thing that I wanted to say that to express is a lot of people don't know that there's private flood insurers and they should look at both quotes side by side.
Absolutely. And we always provide both. Every time we do, it's standardized. We always have one flat rate that we tell them, this is if you were to go with FEMA, this is what you're going to look at. And then this is private flood.
Right.
So we always put a private flood because it's not standardized. It varies by, you know, your house next to another house may be different. But we do have both options, just to make it easier on, you know, transactions with closings and, you know, given maximizing everything for your clients.
Sounds good. All right, Jordan. And Jordan works out of the same office with us at the Annex, which is downtown Pensacola, right on Palafox. So if you ever have any questions, we'll put his contact info below this video if you need him to quote out. What else do you guys do at Goosehead?
We do everything. We have a very robust portfolio with homeowners. We do investment properties, rental. Auto insurance is a big thing for us right now because we're in a no-fault state. We dabble in business commercials as well, but I would say our bread and butter is assisting, you know, lenders, realtors, and your buyers with homes. So,
okay, awesome. Thanks, Jordan. Appreciate you coming out.
Yeah, and, thanks.